Hello, my name is Changbin Guo. I work for SAS R&D in statistical software development, specializing in survival and event history time analysis. In this video, I would like to talk to you about some new features available in SAS 15.1 that lets you analyze the restricted mean survival time. The LifeTest and PHREG procedures in SAS software provide popular survival analysis tools. The LifeTest procedure focuses on nonparametric analysis, and it provides a Kaplan-Meier method for estimating the survival function. And the log rank test for comparing the survival functions from different populations. The PHREG procedure, on the other hand, focuses on regression modeling and supports the popular Cox proportional hazards model. The proportional hazards, or PH assumption, plays a fundamental role in both the log rank test and the Cox regression. The proportional hazards assumption is the basis of the Cox regression. The log rank test can be derived as a score test of the Cox model and have the highest power when the assumption is true. Any violation of the PH assumption influences the performances of the log rank test and the Cox regression. Unfortunately, however, non-proportional hazards are often encountered in practice. A typical violation of the PH assumption occurs when the two survival curves cross. This implies that the corresponding hazard functions would also cross, and therefore violates the PH assumption. Because the log rank statistic is essentially a weighted sum of the hazard function over time, the log rank test can lose much of its power to detect the true difference in survival. Results from the Cox PH regression have the same problem. When the true hazard ratio changes over time, the estimated hazard rate ratio from the fitted model ends up being a weighted average of the time-varying hazard ratios and can be interpreted as such. The problem is that the weights depending on the underlying survival and the censoring distributions and therefore cannot be generalized straightforwardly. The restricted mean survival time, or RMST, is defined as the expected value of the restricted survival time from time zero to tau. The RMST is related to the survival mean. When tau goes to infinity, the RMST becomes the survival mean. The RMST can be more reliably estimated than the mean or median. For example, if the last observation is censored, then the mean becomes inestimable. And when the survival does not drop below 0.5, the median is undefined. You can perform essentially the same types of inferences with respect to the RMST as you can in the classical setting. To compare two groups, you can compare their RMSTs given the same tau value. For regression modeling, you can model the RMST via linear or log linear models. These models enable you to study the effects in the RMST directly. Starting in SAS 15.1, new dedicated features are available for analyzing the RMST. You can use the RMST option in the LifeTest procedure to perform nonparametric analysis with respect to the RMST. You can also use the new RMST reg procedure to fit linear and log linear models of the RMST. In PROC LifeTest, you can perform RMST analysis by specifying the RMST option in the PROC LifeTest statement. When there are multiple groups, you can specify the strata statement to compute the RMST for each level of the strata variable. In addition to generating the survival plot, you can also request the RMST curve by specifying the plot equals option. You can use the max time option to set the upper limits of the time axis for these plots. You can use the diff option in the strata statement to compute the paired differences of the RMST among the groups. To protect yourself from falsely significant results, you can use the ADG option to make multiple comparison adjustments to the p-values. Results from the RMST analyses are displayed following the existing analyses in PROC LifeTest. By default, PROC lifetest uses the smallest value among the largest observed times across the groups as the tau value for the analysis. As you can see from the RMST estimates table, the large and squamous group appear to have larger RMST estimates than the adenoid and the small groups. You can interpret the RMST estimates as expected survival time for the first 186 days. The RMST test for equality table displays results from the homogeneity test that shows whether the RMSTs are the same among the groups. As the p-value indicates, the RMSTs appear to be different among the groups. The RMST curve plots the estimated RMST against different values of the tau. Because the RMST can be computed only for tau values smaller than the largest observed times, the ranges of the RMST curves vary among the groups, with the adenoid group having the shortest range. You can read the estimated RMST values for a specific tau value from the plotted curve by drawing a vertical line. Results from pairwise comparisons suggest that you can divide the four risk groups into two classes. The first class consists of small and adenoid groups, and there is no significant difference in the RMST between them. The second class consists of the large and squamous groups. The paired comparison is not significant. However, there is a significant difference in any paired comparisons between these two classes. You can use the new RMST REG procedure to perform regression analysis of the RMST. The RMST REG procedure is a new addition to the SAS-TEST family for modeling time-to-event data. It compares most closely to PROC LIFETEST and PROC PHREG, but these three procedures have different focuses and support different functionality. The LIFETEST procedure focuses on the time-to-event and feeds accelerated failure time models by maximizing the likelihood function. The PHREG procedure focuses on the hazard function and feeds popular Cox proportional hazard models by maximizing the partial likelihood function. By contrast, PROC RMSTREG focuses on the RMST and feeds certain generalized linear models. Its estimation technique is based on estimating equations. PROC RMSTREG can handle red sensor data, just as PROC PHREG does. It can fit linear and log linear models to the RMST. You can use two estimation techniques, the pseudo-value regression technique and the inverse probability censoring weighting technique, with pseudo-value regression being the default model fitting method. After you fit the model, you can perform many types of post-fitting analysis, just as you can do with generalized linear models. Consider fitting a model for the RMST at a tau value of 10 years with three independent variables, age, bilirubin, and edema. As the code shows, you can specify the tau value for the analysis by using the tau option in PROC RMSTREG. You can include categorical variables in the model by specifying them in the class statement. You can use pseudo-value regression to fit the model by specifying MySERS equals PV. The link equals linear option specifies the linear model. As the equation shows, the model to be analyzed contains a total of five regression parameters that needs to be estimated. Outputs from PROC RMSTREG look like outputs from a standard modeling procedure. The type 3 test results in the analysis of parameter estimates table indicate that all three variables are strong predictors of the RMST at 10 years. Because a linear model of the RMST has been fitted, the estimates are in fact on the RMST scale, and you can interpret them straightforwardly. For example, on average, the RMST is reduced by 0.0686 years with 1 year increase in age. As you have seen from this brief presentation, the restricted mean survival time is a good alternative to the survival outcome. Compared to the survival mean and median, it can be more robustly estimated and is valid when the proportional hazard assumption is validated. Starting in SAS-TEST 15.1, you can use the new RMSTREG procedure to perform regression analysis and the new RMST option in PROC LIFETEST to perform nonparametric analysis. You can consider the RMST option in PROC LIFETEST to be a bonus option because it performs RMST analysis in addition to the existing functionalities in PROC LIFETEST. For more information about restricted mean analysis and other resources, please visit our website at support.sas.com/statistics. You can find the overview papers about new developments and also past SAS Global Forum papers. You can also sign up for newsletters and browse through examples. Thank you for watching.